डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मैसेल धुंडप्पा कुलकर्णी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, डॉक्टर आर बी पाटिल महेश व्यू कॉलेज हुबली. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेक ए सेशन ऑन द के सी टी ऑब्जर्वेबली क्लास ऑन द चैप्टर सीक्वेंस एंड सीरीज सेशन नंबर 2. लेट अस स्टार्ट द सेशन विद द क्वेश्चंस. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, बिकॉज ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड 10 क्वेश्चंस इन द प्रीवियस सेशन, सो इट इज द 11th क्वेश्चन. In a geometric progression, if the ratio of the sum of first 5 terms to the sum of their reciprocals is 49 and the sum of the first and the third term is 35, then the first term of the geometric progression is. Dear students, let us consider option A is 7, option B is 21, option C is 28. Option D 42. So it is already asked in the previous year JEE paper. For the solution, let 5 terms of the geometric progression be a by r square, a by r, a r square. Now reciprocals of these terms are r square by a, r by a, 1 by a, 1 by a r, 1 by a r square. Now we have to consider the given data. We have to consider the ratio of these two terms here. So that here we have a by r square plus a by r plus a plus a r plus a r square divided by their reciprocal sum here, that is r square by a plus r by a plus 1 by a plus 1 by a r plus 1 by a r square is equal to 49. So just we have to do the addition and the cancellation by taking the common terms, and here we the remaining term is what here, that is a square is equal to 49. After all the cancellation, we have a square is equal to 49. Now we can find out the value of a here, that is plus or minus 7. As r square is greater than 0, because r square is the square of r, that square term is always greater than 0 here, it never be negative, therefore a should be positive. And 1 by r square plus 1 is equal to 5. So that implies here r square is equal to 1 by 4, because if you transfer that plus 1 to the right hand side, so then it becomes r square is equal to 1 by 4. Now we have to find out the value of first term. So that the first term will be is equal to a by r square. So that already that r square is equal to 1 by 4. So a by r square is equal to mean that is 7 by 1 by 4 is equal to. So if you take the numerator side, it becomes 7 into 4. So that will be 28. Therefore the right option is 28. That is option C. Question number 12. If the sum of the first 10 terms of the series 1 integer 3 by 5 whole square plus 2 integer 2 by 5 whole square plus 3 integer 1 by 5 whole square plus 4 square plus 4 integer 4 by 5 whole square plus so on is 16 by 5 m, then m is equal to option A 102 means 102, option B 101, option C 100, option D 99. It is also already asked in the previous year GE paper. Let us consider the solution. Note that here we have the terms here. So we can consider the terms 1 3 by 5 comma, 2 2 by 5 comma, 3 integer 1 by 5 comma, 4 comma 4 integer 4 by 5 comma, so on. So these are the terms. They are form an AP. They form an AP with the first term a is equal to 1 integer 3 by 5, because if you just take the common difference, so that will be always equal, and the common difference is here d is equal to 4 by 5. So that here student, I left that squares here, so just I am considering the terms within the brackets here. So they form an AP with the first term a is equal to 1 integer 3 by 5, and the common difference is d is equal to 4 by 5. Now sum to 10 terms. So now let us consider the sum of the 10 terms of the given series. So they are in the square form.
Therefore, the summation of a plus k minus 1 into d whole square, because these are the square terms here, but the terms are in the form of ap, so that here I am taking that kth term in the form of square, and that k is from 1 to 10. So this is the summation. Now we have to apply the summation for each term here. So before that, here I will show you that the summation of this whole term will be, that is here k, it is from 1 to 10, so that here we will be getting that summation is 10 into a square plus, here that will be here 2ad into the bracket of, that is k minus 1 means you have to consider k is from 1 to 10, so that we have 1 plus 2 plus so on plus up to 9, plus again d square into that k minus 1 whole square, so that k minus 1 whole square means that is here 1 square plus 2 square plus 1 plus 9 square. So this is here the form of this given summation. Now we can apply the values here. So 10 a square plus ad into, here already we have that is 2ad means here we can apply that terms are here, that is 9 terms, so that n into n plus 1 means that is 9 into 10 divided by 2, so 2 cancelled, we have that is ad into 9 into 10 plus again d square into the sum of the squares of the first 9 natural numbers here, so that we can apply the formula here directly, so that 1 by 6 into that is 9 into 10 into 19. Now in the next step you can apply the value of a here, so that a value is equal to what here, that is 1 into the 3 by 5 means we can take this one in the simplest form, that is 5 into 1 is 5 plus 3 is equal to 8, so 8 by 5, therefore we can apply the value of a here, so 10 into 8 by 5 whole square plus 8 by 5 into 4 by 5 into 9 into 10 plus 4 square by 5 square into 15 into 19. Now you have to simplify to get the answer. Therefore, here we can take the 16 by 5 common from all these terms. Therefore, the remaining terms within the bracket, they are 8 plus 36 plus 57. So, after adding the terms here, we have 16 by 5 into 101. Therefore, if you just compare that sum is equal to 16 by 5 m means, so that we have that value of m is equal to 101. Therefore, the right option is B, because the value of m is equal to 101. Question number 13. If m is the m of two distinct real numbers L and n, L and n are greater than 1, here this is the given condition, and g1, g2 and g3 are three geometric means between L and n, then g1 raised to 4 plus 2 into g2 raised to 4 plus g3 raised to 4 equals option A 4l square mn, option B 4l m square n, option C 4l m n square, option D 4l square m square n square. Now let us consider the solution of this given question. Here that m is m means, that is here m value is equal to here that L plus N divided by 2, because this is that M is the AM of two real numbers L and N. Also here we can take that geometric means between L and N, so L G1 G2 G3 N R in GP, let its common ratio be small r, then N is equal to L into r to the power 4, because that N becomes the fifth term of this geometric progression, and also we can write it as here r raised to 4 is equal to n by l, just by transferring that l to the left hand side, then it is becoming here divisible by, therefore n by l is equal to r raised to 4. Now we can consider that g1 raised to 4 plus 2 into g2 raised to 4 plus g3 raised to 4, so g1 here it is the next term of L, so that here we can multiply R to the L, so this becomes G1 is equal to LR, and similarly G2 is equal to L into R square, and G3 is equal to L into R cube. So now we can apply values here, therefore by taking means
first we have to write the power 4 and later we can take out that L raised to 4 here. So the remaining terms within the bracket are R raised to 4 plus 2 into R square whole to the power 4 plus R cube whole to the power 4. Now here take down that here R raised to 4 is equal to n by L. We can apply that value here. So L raised to 4 into the bracket of n by L plus 2 into n square by L square plus n cube by L cube. Now we can take the LCM, so that LCM is L cube. So for the first term in the bracket, we have to multiply L square. For the second term, we have to multiply L. And later we can take out that n common from the numerator as well as L cube from the denominator after cancelling that L to the power 4 divided by L cube. So we have that is L into n. After taking n common, L into n, within the bracket we have L square plus 2nl plus n square. Here just we have to remember the formula of algebra. Therefore L square plus 2nl plus n square can be written as L plus n whole square. Therefore ln into L plus n whole square, so that L plus n is equal to here 2m, because m is equal to L plus n divided by 2 is here. Therefore L plus n is equal to 2m, so we can apply that value here. So that 2m whole square means that is 4m square. So by multiplying we have 4lm square n. Therefore the right option is B. Let us consider the 14th question. If a1, a2, a3, so on n and so on are in AP such that a4 minus a7 plus a10 is equal to m, then sum of the first 13 terms of the AP is option A 10m, option B 12m, option C 13m, option D 15m. Let us consider the solution. Let D be the common difference of the given AP, then m is equal to, already it is given that a4 minus a7 plus a10, this can also be written as a4 plus a10 minus a7, so just we can represent by a bracket. Now we can write that a4 is equal to, that is a1 plus 3d, so that the difference between a10 and a7 will be also equal to 3d only. Therefore a1 plus 6d, therefore m will be equal to a1 plus 16d. Now we have to find out the sum of the first 13 terms of the AP. So this will be here equal to S13 is equal to 13 by 2 into the bracket of 2 into A1 plus 13 minus 1 into D by applying the SN formula. So we can get here 2 into A1 plus 12D. So after taking 2 common and by cancelling by the denominator, therefore we will be having A1 plus 6D within the bracket. So that we can write it as here 13 into m, because a1 plus 6d is equal to already m. Therefore 13m is the sum of 13 terms in this given problem. Therefore the right option is C. Now we will go for the question number 15. The sum of first 20 terms of the sequence 0.7, 0.77, 0.777, comma so on is option A 7 by 9 into the bracket of 99 minus 10 to the power minus 20, option B 7 by 81 into the bracket of 179 plus 10 to the power minus 20, option C 7 by 9 into the bracket of 99 plus 10 to the power minus 20, option D 7 by 81 into the bracket of 179 minus 10 to the power minus 20. Let us consider the solution of this given problem. First, I would like to consider the sum of all these given terms. Therefore, S is equal to here 0.7 plus 0.77 plus 0.777 plus 1 plus up to 20 terms, because we don't know that 20th term here. So just I will take here up to here 20 terms, the sum. It can also be written as here by taking 9 by 9, 9 by 9, and also by taking 7 common parts. So after taking 7 common and also by multiplying 9 by 9, we have 7 by 9 into the bracket of 0.9 plus 0.99 plus 0.999 plus so on up to 20 terms. Dear students, so that 0.9 can be written as 1 minus 0.1. Similarly, 0.99 can be written as here 1 minus 0.01. plus 0.999 can be written as 1 minus 0.001 up to 20 terms. So that here we will be adding all the terms within the bracket. Also we have 7/9 into the bracket of 1 is adding 20 times, so that it becomes 20 minus into the bracket of, we can take all the terms within the bracket, therefore we have 0.1 plus 0.01 plus 0.001 plus so on up to 20 terms. Now we have 7/9 into the bracket of 20 minus that all the terms within the bracket, they are in the form of JP, therefore we can apply the sum of terms in the GP, therefore we can apply the formula 7/9 into the bracket of here 20 minus that 0.1 is the first term, so that we can take it as here 1/10 only, and that common ratio will be also equal to 1/10 only, therefore we can apply the formula of sum of n term, that is a into the bracket of 1 minus r to the power n divided by 1 minus r, therefore we can apply the value of a and r here. Therefore, within the bracket, we have 20 minus 1/10 into the bracket of 1 minus 1/10 whole to the power 20 whole divided by 1 minus 1/10. So, dear student, in the numerator, we have that is 1/10. In the denominator, 1 minus 1/10 means we can take the LCM of that denominator is here, that is 10 only, so that we can write it as 10 minus 1/10 means 9/10, and that 1/10 we can write properly, so 10/10 will be cancelled, in the denominator 9 is remaining, so that 9 can be taken as your LCM, so 9 into 20 is 180 minus into the bracket of 1 minus 1/10 whole to the power 20 is remained, therefore we can write it as here 7/81 into the bracket of here, that is 180 minus 1 will be equal to 179, and minus into minus becomes plus, and that 1/10 whole to the power 20 can also be written as 10 to the power minus 20. Therefore, 7/81 into the bracket of 179 plus 10 to the power minus 20 is the answer. So, the right option is B. The students, just here we are not possible to here solve all the steps here. So, that just I will here dictate all the steps here. So, that just you can do the practice to get this simplification. The question number 16, given sum of the first n terms of an AP is 2n plus 3n square, another AP is formed with the same first term and is double the common difference. The sum of n terms of the new AP is option A n plus 4n square, option B 6n square minus n, option C n square plus 4n, option D 3n plus 2n square. Consider the solution. Sn, it is given here, that is Sn is equal to n plus 3n square. Now we can find out the value of A here is equal to S1, because S1 is also equal to A only here, because it is the sum of first term only. So it is will be, we will get the value of S1 by putting n is equal to 1 in Sn. Therefore, 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1 square is here, that is 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Now we can take down here, that is S2 here. So S2 means that is here A plus T, because sum of first two terms is equal to S2. So that S2 can also be getting by replacing n by 2 here, 2 into 2 plus 3 into 2 square. Therefore, we have that is 4 plus 12 is equal to 16. The students, here we have a plus d is equal to 16, therefore a is already equal to 5, therefore d is equal to 16 minus 10, because 16 minus 2a is equal to d here, so the d is equal to 16 minus 10, because a value is 5, therefore 16 minus 10 is equal to 6, so this is the value of d. Now we have to find out the sum of the required AP, because the second AP. So in that the first term is same, but the common difference is double, means we have to consider 2D for the common difference. Now we have that sum of n terms here. So n by 2 into the bracket of 2a plus n minus 1 into 2d, because instead of d we have to take 2d. So n by 2 we can apply 2 into 5 plus n minus 1 into 2 into 6.
And now here we can simplify the term within the bracket here. 25 10 plus 12 n minus 12, and after taking the common, 2 common we can cancel, and the remaining terms we can multiply here. So we have 6 n square minus n, because within the bracket we have 6 n minus 1. So by multiplying n here, we have that is 6 n square minus n is the required answer. Therefore, the right option is B. Question number 17.
Let A1, A2, A3 be an AP such that A1 plus A2 plus so on plus AP divided by A1 plus A2 plus so on plus AQ is equal to P square by Q square. Here that P is not equal to Q, then A6 by A21 is equal to. Let us consider the options here. Option A is equal to 421 by 11. Option B is equal to 121 by 1681. Option C is equal to 11 by 41. Option D is equal to 121 by 1861. Now consider the solution. Let D be the common difference of the AP. Then that the ratio, the given ratio will be written as here P by 2 into the bracket of 2A1 plus P minus 1 into D divided by that denominator can be written as Q by 2 into the bracket of 2A1 plus Q minus 1 into D, because here we can consider the sum of first P terms in the numerator, sum of Q terms in the denominator. Therefore, it is equal to P square by Q square. This implies here we can just take down, we'll take out that two common here we have A1 two common, and by cancelling in the numerator as well as here denominator, we have A1 plus 1 by 2 P minus 1 into D divided by A1 plus 1 by 2 into the bracket of Q minus 1 into D is equal to P by Q, because that P and P also cancelled in both LHS and RHS, and also we can cancel that Q also. And now we have to find out A6 by A21 is equal to, so A6 means it is equal to, that is A1 plus 5D, so that we should get 1 by 2 P minus 1 should be equal to 5. Therefore, P can be putting as here, that is P is equal to 11. Similarly, for the denominator, we should get A21. A21 means it is nothing but that is A1 plus 20D. So to get 20 in the place of 1 by 2 into Q minus 1, we should put it as here, Q is equal to 41. Therefore, we have to put P is equal to 11 and Q is equal to 41. We get, that is A1 plus 5D divided by A1 plus 20D. So it is nothing but A6 by A21 is equal to 11 by 4, 41. Therefore, the right option is C. Question number 18. G be the geometric mean of two positive numbers A and B, and M be the arithmetic mean of 1 by A and 1 by B. If 1 by M is to G is 4 is to 5, then A is to B can be. Option A 1 is to 4, option B 1 is to 2, option C 2 is to 3, option D 3 is to 4. Let us consider the solution. G be the geometric mean of two positive numbers A and B, means we can write it as G is equal to square root of AB, and that M is arithmetic mean of 1 by A and 1 by B, means 1 by 2 into the bracket of 1 by A plus 1 by B, which can also be written as here A plus B divided by 2AB after simplifying this one. And now the given data, that is also 1 by M is to G, means here 1 by M divided by G is equal to 4 by 5. So just we can simplify this one here, it becomes 1 by mg is equal to 4 by 5. So mg is equal to 5 by 4. So that m is equal to 1 by, that is a plus b by 2ab, and g is equal to square root of ab. So just by cancelling square root of ab in the numerator part, so that square root of ab is remained in the denominator. So therefore, a plus b divided by 2 into square root of ab is equal to 5 by 4 is remained. And by dividing separately means a by 2 into square root of ab plus b divided by 2 into square root of ab, we have that is square root of a by b plus square root of b by a is equal to 5 by 2, because 2 is cancelled here. 2 into means 2 by that is 2 into 2 is 4 here, so that here we can cancel on either side. So 2 1 ja 2 2 ja, therefore here it will be equal to pi by 2. Now that we have to here verify this one here, so that square root of a by b plus square root of b by a is equal to pi by 2 means, so this is in the form of x plus 1 by x is equal to pi by 2. Therefore that square root of a by b, which may be in the form of 1 by 2, or here it may be in the form of 2 here. And to get the required term, we have to find out a is to b means a by b. So to find out that one here, I have to square on both side, so that a by b is equal to 1 by 4 or 4. But here if you just observe all the options here, so that 4 is to 1 is not there, so definitely 1 is to 4 is the right option. Therefore the right option is option A. The 19th question, fifth term of a GP is 2, then the product of its 9 terms is option A 256, option B 512, option C 1024, option D 2048. Let us consider the solution. T5 is equal to 2, and let R be the common ratio of this given GP. Now we can take down the product of that 9 terms, means T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6, T7, T8, T9 is equal to, here T5 is 2, means here for the remaining terms we can get by multiplying R. Right, therefore T6 is equal to here 2 by 2 into R, and T7 is equal to 2 into R square, T8 is equal to 2 into R cube, and T9 is equal to 2 into R to the power 4. But T4 can be getting here 2 by R, T3 we can get by 2 by R square, T2 is 2 by R cube, and T1 is 2 by R to the power 4. So just we can consider like this here, because T5 is equal to 2 and the common ratio is R. So now consider the product here, so that here product will be equal to 2 by R to the power 4 into 2 by R cube, 2 by R square into 2 by R, that fifth term is 2, and sixth term is 2R, and seventh term is 2 into R square, eighth term is 2 into R cube, and the ninth term is 2 into R to the power 4. By just cancelling here that R to the power 4, R to the power 4, R to the power cube, and R to the R square, and R, after all cancelling them here, we have 2 to the power 9. So that we can get the answer by multiplying 2 9 times. So 2 to the power 9 will be equal to 512 will be the right answer. Therefore the right option is B. Similarly, we will take the last example, 20th question. The value of 2 to the power 4 1 by 4 into 4 to the power 1 by 8 into a to the power 1 by 16, so on up to infinity is option A1, option B2, option C 3 by 2, option D 4. Let us consider the solution. Dear student, here we have infinite number of terms here. Here in the sequence, here we have 2 to the power 4, 1 by 4 into 4 to the power 1 by 8 into a to the power 1 by 16. Let us consider this whole as here e is equal to that product of all those terms up to infinity. So this will be is equal to 2 to the power 5. Where S is equal to 1 by 4 plus 2 by 8 plus 3 by 16 plus 4 by 32 plus so on. Because dear students, I am considering the power of 2, 4, 8 here, successive terms here, so that we have 1 by 4 plus 2 by 8 plus 3 by 16 plus 4 by 32 plus so on. One here, this implies just by multiplying 1 by 2 to the S, so that in the RHS part also you have to multiply here, it becomes 1 by 8 plus 2 by 16 plus 3 by 32 plus so on. And subtracting these two here, we get here S minus 1 by 2 S, means again it is 1 by 2 S is equal to, that is 1 by 4 minus 1 by 8 is equal to 1 by 4, 2/8 minus 2/16 is equal to 1/8. Similarly, we can just subtracting all those terms here. We have 1/4 plus 1/8 plus 1/16 plus 1/32 plus so on in the RHS part. Therefore, here we can take here the solution, mean we can get here that the given series is in the form of geometric series. Therefore, that 1/4 is the first term and 1/2 is the common ratio. And here we have infinite number of terms, so that we can apply the formula a/(1 - r). a/(1 - r) means a is equal to 1/4, r is equal to 1/2. Therefore, 1 - 1/2 in the denominator. So 1 - 1/2 means it is 1/2. And if we take that 2 to the numerator side, it becomes here 2/4. So 2/4 is equal to 1/2. Dear student, 1/2, yes, is equal to 1/2 is here. So by cancelling 1/2 on both sides, we have s is equal to 1. Therefore, that s means here, that is in the first equation, that 2 to the power, that is s only, not that is 5. So 2 to the power s is there, and s is equal to 1 means e is equal to 2 to the power 1. E is equal to 2 to the power 1 because that s is equal to 1 here. So e to the power 2 to the power 1 is equal to, that is e is equal to 2. Therefore, the right option is B. So just it is make correction, student. So in the first equation, that is 2 to the power 1/4 into 4 to the power 1/8 into 8 to the power 1/16, so on up to infinite terms, is equal to 2 to the power s, that is not 5, 2 to the power s. So that s value is equal to 1, therefore e becomes, that is 2. Therefore, the right option is B. And after all these here question, here I am going to end this session, student. I will continue some more examples in the next session. Until that, here, bye. Take care, students. Thank you.